Hi, I'm Josh.
And I'm Arielle. Welcome to this edition of Pirate Nation News.
Today we will be highlighting something you all have an interest in, snow days.
Many of us wonder exactly what conditions we need to have the day off.
Well, here is a PNN exclusive interview with our superintendent, Dr. Jack Thompson.
So, Dr. Thompson, what do you do to determine a snow day?
Well, Colin, there's a lot of variables going to determining whether we're going to be able to allow our kids to come into school. I don't do it on my own. I have a number of folks that go out and drive the roads for me. We look at multiple forecast predictions, and I talk to other area superintendents, and so we try to gather as much information as we can to determine, you know, whether it's going to be safe enough for our kids to go to school. And depending on where you live geographically, and it can be a tough decision. Certainly with where we live with lake effect snows, you know, when we have these snow bands coming in, it can be a matter of, you know, a half a mile where some places are getting snow and some places aren't.
Right, right.
And then you have your temperature and your freezing and your wind chill advisories, mm-hmm. and all those things come into play. So, you need up to the minute information. And the real troubling part is you know, this starts at 4:30, and you're trying to make a decision at 5:00 about how the conditions are going to be at 7 when the kids come out of the school. So sometimes things look great at 5:00 a.m. And then at 7:30 or 7:45, right when the kids are out there, we get hit with an unpredictable snow band, and people are saying, what was Dr. Thompson thinking by having
you
school?
Take the heat for that, yeah.
So it's a very difficult, stressful time when you have to make those decisions.
Yeah. Are there any guidelines that you follow, or do you kind of just like go off of your own guidelines knowing what's safe for the kids?
Yeah, it depends again on the type of district. You know, we have a lot of kids that ride school buses. We don't have a lot of walkers.
Yeah.
And so you're thinking about, kids at bus stops, how long are they going to have to wait? We had one condition earlier this year where the temperature was going to be okay in the morning, but it looked like during the day things were going to fall down below, you know, some pretty severe wind conditions and so forth and so on. So you try to think about, you know, how we'll be getting home. Will we get kids in here and then have 8 inches or 12 inches of snow, make it dangerous to get them back? So there really is no set guideline. Again, the wind chills are a factor. Then the amount of predicted snow versus the amount of snow you have, are the roads passable? And so you take all these things into consideration depending on, and again, the weather. It can vary too as far as, are we in conditions of ice? Where you're at that black ice stage where the temperature's iffy, where we could have some periods of that. So, again, depends on what's going on out there, and so there really isn't any standard at all.
All right. Do you believe in any snow day rituals?
I'm a very, you know, I believe in ritual and tradition and those things, and I think it's fun for kids to turn their pajamas inside out and do all those things but in the end, it's all as a matter of just collecting the facts and trying to make a good, sound decision to keep our kids as safe as possible, knowing that we live in Ohio and in winter weather, and we're all, you know, pretty good about that. And and just like kids in Wisconsin go to school in conditions that we wouldn't, because they've adapted and they're used to that, and they know it's going to be negative 30 degree wind chill, and they're ready for that, where we typically aren't.
Yeah.
So.
All right. How do you spend your snow days?
Well, a snow day, you know, it starts, like I said, 4:00 a.m. And so I get up and, you know, we determine, you know, whether we're going to make that call. And then we decide whether, okay, so now we have a snow day. What are the long-term conditions? Are there activities at night? Is the CFC going to open up for our community members to come in and work on that? Are we able to get crews in to clear the snow? I usually come into work at some point in time. The thing about my job, it's not predicated on whether children are here or not. I'm not, although I work for the benefit of students, I'm not responsible for supervising students per se. So my work's still there, and as long as, we've got crews in and we can clear it, I usually come in at some point in time or on occasions we work from home. It's a little bit of a different day. Mm-hmm. Hopefully I can get a nap in there somewhere along the way, but the rougher days are the ones where it's a snow day potential that turns into a school day, because then I'm up at 4 a.m. doing all the, we're doing all the things that we're doing, and we decide it's a go, and then we're in, then we're in at 7:30 just like normal, and we just had a little bit of an earlier start. Yeah. So those are long days.
Yeah.
And those happen quite a bit in the winter. Mm-hmm.
So just another day of work.
Yes.
All right. Well, do you follow Mark Johnson on Twitter?
No, I don't follow Mark Johnson on Twitter. However, a number of people that follow me send his tweets my way. The media can be a very problemsome situation. Again, we do rely on meteorologists and the weather forecasts, and we certainly pay attention to those things. But depending on what's going on, and usually those first storms, I don't want to say that they're hyped. Yeah. By the media, but they certainly utilize those to increase their viewership, and that can cause us some issues, because at times, I think early on this year, I think Mark Johnson had a lot to do with some of the early closures that mm-hmm. happened. When you're predicting predicting severe weather, we know their percentage of getting it just right isn't that good.
No.
I typically want to wait and see what happens in the conditions, because although I would love to cancel school on a Friday, Thursday night so I could sleep in, it doesn't make sense to me when I could have been totally wrong and missed it. So I don't appreciate what the media does, pumping those things up and making it a storm appear to be potentially more severe than it is. But in the end, we certainly want to let everyone know that our conditions can be dangerous. Mm-hmm. We need to be aware of those things and respect the winter weather that we have out here and those conditions, because we don't want folks getting hurt, and they need to be careful. So those are tough situations.
All right. Thank you very much. Thank you for being here.
Yep.
I appreciate
yep.
it.
Anytime.
Thank you. Yeah. This has been an interview with Dr. Jack.
Hopefully that answers all of your questions. Now we can look forward to our snow day.
Well, speaking of snow, let's take a look at our weather to see if there's any snow in our forecast.
Throughout the weekend and this next week, you can expect multiple snow showers with a high of 35 degrees and a low of 18 degrees. With the weekend being filled with snow and the rest of the week cold but partly cloudy, maybe there's a snow day in our future. Now over to sports.
This past week, the boys' basketball team beat Kenston with a final score of 50-47. With that win, the boys keep first place in the CVC. The current record for the boys is 9-1. Let's take a look at some of their highlights so far this season.
We'll be right back.
That's impressive. Make sure you come to their game at home tonight at 7. Way to go, Pirates. In other sports news, our gymnast Haley Moskowitz placed 5th all around at the meet Wednesday night. Way to go, Haley. In swimming news, this past Friday, the girls beat both Laurel and Beechwood. Also on Tuesday, both the girls and boys swim team beat Cleveland Heights, now making the girls' record 7-2 and the boys 2-6. The swimmers and divers compete in the CVC meet this Saturday at Hawken. Good luck, Pirates.
I'm living in that 21st century, doing something mean to it. Do it better than anybody you ever seen do it. Screams from the haters, got a nice ring to it. I guess every superhero need his theme music. No one man should have all that power. The clock's ticking, I just count the hours. Stop tripping, I'm tripping off the power. Broken, the school's closed, the prison's open. We ain't got nothing to lose. Everybody, we rollin'. Everybody, we rollin'. With some light-skinned girls and some Kelly Rollins. And this white man world, we the ones chosen. So good night, cruel world. I see you in the morning. I see you in the morning. This is way too much. I need a moment. No one man should have all that power. The clock's ticking. I just count the hours. I'm tripping off the power. Till then, that the world's ours. Kissing Nail and the whole cast. Tell them Easy said they could kiss my whole ass. More specifically, they could kiss my ass. I'm an ass. Napoleon, my furs is Mongolian. My ice brought the goalies and I embody every characteristic of the egotistic. He knows, he's so f***ing gifted. I just needed time.
Keep up the good work, swimmers. Also, this past Tuesday, our divers competed with Haley Moskowitz placing 2nd and Brenna Freeman placing 4th. Now back to Ariel and Josh at the news desk.
Wow, our pirate athletes are really working hard and it's showing.
Yes, all of our teams deserve the recognition of their hard work. Well, that's it for this week.
See you next week, Pirates, and good luck to our athletes competing this weekend.